here was another collection to start compiling. Mostly mail ordering. Ordering schizoid. The only problem with mail ordering things was that I could never forget I had mail ordered the things. Nice. Our correspondence was sporadic, but he would send me whatever new books he had coming out. They kept coming, and I kept writing. Here's the Beatles postcard he must have sent me, November 1995. It says,
"Your words are endless in my heart's apple. Thank you. Here's me lately, busy, tired, dad, juice, thinking about buying a new computer, writing, remixing others' poems, on acid, opening for Jim Carroll in front of 200 people, Connie Chung, fucking freaking and peeking, having fun juggling my words with other people's heads. I've seen little of your work, I'd like to see more. How's school, or work, or life, death? What's up with Stovepiper?
Stovepiper was an anthology I published. It cost me $4,000. Mostly poetry. Poetry cost me $4,000. That's what interested me most about Kevin Samsel. The poetry. The poetry of it. Even the short stories of Kevin Samsel were poetry. I was interested. I was into it. So, let's start something special. Words of the Eternal Con Artist. Head. 13 girls on the fire. Acid, dental, haiku, you family value pack, literary snobs, beautiful teenagers unite. Awkward. Magic time bomb. All of the above is what I would call Kevin Samsel American poetry. All of the above is what I would call Kevin Samsel American poetry. All of the above is what I would call Kevin Samsel American poetry. Check. And all of it came out before 1995. Kevin Samsel was new. It was new to me. He was new to me. I didn't know you could do what he did and kept doing. Keep going. I didn't know you were allowed. What was so interesting about the weird sex and the starting to feel the love.
You want blood?
He wrote to me on 5/16/96.
At work.
He wrote under the date. He ran a coffee kiosk at the time.
You got it.
He wrote this letter on the back of a solar yellow flyer listing titles that were then available from Future Tense Books. 15 titles were available. Looked like some weird shit that was available. Future Tense Books was also selling Black and Purple Corporate Poetry Still Sucks t-shirts for $10. And country music haiku posters. 18 Haiku by Kevin Samsel. Each named after a different country music singer. The posters were $2 each, were free, with a book order. And I got mine with a book order. Signed. Said he was a disc jockey on a country music radio station in Spokane, Washington, and his chapbook, 13 Girls on Fire, was banned in Eugene, Oregon, and all across Canada. His letter says,
you want blood? You got it. You want sex? You got it. You want food? You got it. You want a large, rubber, shimmering, blue, slightly leaking, excuse me. Hello, Mickey. I was just brushing up on my shock poetry therapy. When I got your postcard last week, I didn't know whether, mostly clappy, to laugh or cry. I ended up driving into a pet store for the sheer thrill of it. Just because. I'm writing a decent amount and just published this strange red thing. Also running a reading series. Getting ready to publish loads of product. Send you my new chat. In a month when it's born. Somebody told me that Richard Speck was in a drug-enhanced porno shot somewhere in his prison. I hear his breasts are big like an old lady. Hormones. Now I want to go to prison. Anxious to hear what you've been doing. Will you contribute to society ever again? Pipe stoven. Drunk vigilante. Pop singer. Mask. Country singer. Football uniform. Spend countless minutes talking to you in my head. Lieutenant Chief Kevin Samsel.
To a commercial.